Subscribe to LabX and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any episodes of Chemist in the Kitchen.
You know, we keep saying ramekin. I know there's like a dad joke in there saying a rama don't.
Rama can't.
I mean, I have no idea what's going on.
Welcome back for another episode of Chemists in the Kitchen. Today we're all stretching our culinary muscles and making a souffle for the first time ever. So we'll be making a dark chocolate souffle and we're gonna see whose souffle achieves the highest heights. So it'll be a sort of a classy chemist cook-off.
Hi, my name is Adrian. I'm a physical chemist and I work at a medical device company outside Chicago.
Hi, I'm Robin. I'm a chemical engineer with a background in polymer science and engineering research.
Hello everyone, my name is Benny Ng. My background is also in physical chemistry. Right now I'm teaching at a community college in Los Angeles, Pierce College. So I teach general chemistry. But in terms of my baking experience, I have...
I'm not sure that I've ever eaten a souffle, but I've had a lot of desserts that use the same concept of, you know, you create a trapped air bubble and then in the oven, the air bubble expands, but hopefully it stays trapped.
In order to do that, we need to create a shell. And egg whites are all made of protein. We don't want the fat part into it. But in this case, we want to make a protein shell and we want to whip it full of air. And so just imagine all these protein molecules are these long, like spaghetti-like strands. And as we whip it, they start to like lock in together. And so when we start to cook it, right, that air is going to expand. And ideally, like Benny says, we don't want to whip it too much because we want that elasticity and we want it to hold. And so we want the proteins to stretch, but not stretch so much that it snaps. Other than experience, we actually don't have like a measurement to actually know that we've actually got it right. And I guess we're going to find out.
All right, well, let's go ahead and get started making our souffles. Most important step is to turn on the oven to make sure that it's preheated in time for the souffles to get in there. The next step is to prepare the ramekins. So we're going to butter and sugar them.
This step is so crucial, right? Because I mean, if we don't, I want to win.
My butter got super hot, so I'm using my fingers that are freshly washed. Hopefully nobody's grossed out online.
How are you guys lining this? You're just putting the sugar in there and then just start coating it?
Yeah, so usually I put like an excessive amount of whatever and then kind of knock it around and dump out the extra. I feel like I'm using too much butter, but I guess we'll see.
There's no consequence to that, I don't think. Oh, unless
we'll see.
Too much
we'll
fat.
See.
Well,
yeah.
Focus.
Yeah, mine is a little clumpy. The butter.
That's a lot of butter.
I know.
You use way more butter than I did.
Yeah, it might be a mistake.
So are we ready for step number two now, I guess? Put 2.5 cups of water in a 3-quart saucepan and then put that on the stove, medium heat. And then we're gonna get a large heat-proof bowl that will sit comfortably on top of the pot without toppling or touching the water below.
It can be anything, but I'm using like a glass bowl over a pot.
Yeah, a double boiler, right?
Yes.
All right, so just pretty much the chocolates and then the whipping cream is what we need to add in there, right?
Yes.
The next steps are cocoa powder, water, and vanilla extract. And I want you to go until it's smooth. After that, you add those three things. Leave a bowl on top of a pot of hot water off the heat to keep the ganache warm. So here's the water. It smells really good. I don't know.
Yeah.
So it's a teaspoon of vanilla. I'm just gonna eyeball.
Yeah, so how's your chocolate looking with the cocoa powder mixed in?
It looks ganache-y.
I think I've just finished number three, so yeah, I think we can start doing the egg white. What is the best way to separate the yolk?
So I'm gonna do that one method that you always see on like other videos. So I'm gonna use one of these like water bottles, and I'm just gonna like suction out the egg yolk.
Oh yeah?
How are you doing, Benny? Where are you at?
I think I got some yolk.
Uh-oh. This is our chance, Robin.
Yeah!
Are you gonna start whipping? Okay. What's your technique?
Well, I'm gonna use this electric thingy here. Okay, so I think I'm kind of there, so let's see. You see how the peak kind of stays there?
I see that. I'm not there yet.
I think that's done.
There's a part of me that doesn't want to give in and use the electric thing, but like, my arm is tired. It's good, I want to see you do this first, because I want to make, if you mess up, then I can watch this.
So I have mixed in some of the egg whites, and now I'm going to add this to the bowl of egg whites. So you first, the chocolate mixture is really heavy. It's full of fat, and chocolate actually has a lot of protein. So you first want to add some of the egg whites to make that mixture a little bit lighter so that when you add it to your egg white, it doesn't just all deflate, right? Like we talked about how important it was to not have the egg yolks in the egg whites. You're kind of adding all of this fat into your egg whites. And you, since you've done the hard work of creating this nice foam, you don't want to destroy it.
So I have done what you have done, Robin. And so you put a fourth of this cup into the chocolate.
Yep.
And you just fold it in?
Yeah.
You take that thing that's in your hand.
Uh-huh.
And you...
If you say fold in one more time.
It says fold it in!
And again, the folding is because if you were to just mix it really vigorously, you just beat all of those nice air bubbles right out of there that you just added.
I'm still beating the egg whites. They're not... They're still pretty liquidy.
Just keep, have faith and keep going, man.
I know, I don't know if that's because of the little yolk that got inside or is this just takes a long time.
And it says to fill it just to the top.
Okay, of the mixture, the chocolatey mixture?
Yeah, to the top of the ramekin.
Benny's been the quietest. I feel like he's got like the stealthy, it might be the stealthy souffle. I don't know if we were watching him. Did he add tartare? Tartaric acid. Ooh, this is very exciting. I can feel this, guys. I can feel the win. I'm feeling confident. Did you put yours in the oven already?
No, I'm waiting.
I put a quarter of the egg white, and I guess it's the folding process right now.
This is good. I'm glad we all did this together. I feel more connected.
I guess it's almost good enough. So now we just have to put them all together.
Are we all doing this?
Yeah, and cooking for 13 minutes is...
Okay, I'm in the oven.
Same here, 13 minutes.
Okay. Let's do it all together. Let me know, I'm gonna stop my timer. You're pulling out now? Oh, Robin already did, okay.
Oh, I'm done.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
I look stable to me now.
What? No, it has to be stable. Wait, let's put a rule at 5 minutes, right?
I'm gonna measure now just for my own curiosity, and
okay.
Then we can wait.
Let's,
we can wait.
Let's do that. Okay, let's do that. Then we'll measure. Wait, how are we measuring? Just from the top to the bottom of the ramekin?
Yeah.
I think that's the easiest.
Okay.
Centimeter or inches?
Oh, mine doesn't have centimeters. Mine only has inches.
Oh, Robin.
I'm sorry.
You guys want to tell me your numbers so I can add them up when you're ready. And then we'll do the 5 minute mark after you're done. Okay, so I'll say at the time 0 point, okay? So Robin's average was 7.7 plus or minus 0.1. Then mine was 7.6 plus or minus 0.2. And Benny's was a 6.8 plus or minus 0.3. In this case, there's somewhat of a statistical tie, but Robin does have a higher average, okay? Now, T equals 5 minutes, okay? We have Robin with 6.3 plus or minus 0.2. We have myself at 6.4 plus or minus 0.1. And we have Benny at 5.7 plus or minus 0.3. So, I don't know. I mean, it's really close.
Yeah, You made a more stable souffle.
Maybe I did. If this doesn't matter because we're all winners. The real test is in tasting them.
It's pretty delicious.
Is it?
It's chocolatey. It's moist. It's fluffy.
This is what mine looks like. It tastes like a soft, pillowy cloud. This is really good. You make this for somebody, that shows you care.
It's actually like less difficult than I was expecting. Like, I've always been intimidated by souffles, but I feel like if you just follow the steps, understand the science, you got a souffle going.
Mm-hmm. No, it helped to have to talk to somebody.
Yeah. Do you think you would try to manually whip your egg whites ever again?
Absolutely not. It did all the things that we wanted to do. Rose, deflated. I don't know if there's a measure of like who the highest souffle means the tastiest, but this is great. It's impressive. All right, so we tally the numbers and it looks like we're all pretty much close to each other. So I would declare this a victory for all. Yay!
Except except I won.
Yeah, well, that's, we'll give it to you.
I'm just kidding.
Robin gets the Nobel Prize. That's fine. And the $50,000 that come with it.
So first of all, I'd like to thank Adrian and Robin because finally I got to bake something, and again, thank you for, you know, guiding me through the process with both of you helping and supporting.
Bye, thanks for watching.
Bye.
I do think I'm gonna eat a second one.
I know. It's just so good. I know.
It's so hard to talk, I just keep eating.
Exactly.